Soon as you walk out your door of your home, there's a cop on the street doing nothing. He's literally getting paid to do nothing. People are losing their life. People are dying. People are sex trafficking. People are getting killed, murdered. But he's on the corner right there making sure everybody goes 15 in the neighborhood. Or that nobody runs that stop sign nobody cares about in the neighborhood.
Ricky!
License and registration, ma'am. I said license and registration. Sir, what did I do? Ma'am, you was going 15 and a 10. But sir, it's only 5 miles over. I don't care, ma'am. And have you been drinking tonight, ma'am? What is that, ma'am? Oh, it's that sweet tea. Oh, it's that sweet tea. You can go ahead with the warning, ma'am. Drive safely. Hey, man. I need everybody to get their license and registration out right now. I know your car don't got no insurance on it, I know. But pull your license and registration out. Hey, we're going to the UK. Hey, man, I know Sweet Tea Gang, we here, man. Double K family, Double K, man, we here, man. Hey, it's all coming together, man. Hope y'all having a wonderful day. I'm here to brighten everybody's soul up, brighten everybody's day up. We got a banger today, man. American cops versus British cops. Bobbies. What the fuck? What is a bobby, dude? What the fuck is a bobby? But anyways, though, we finna figure out what everything is today. I do not know British cops like that or at all. So that's kind of why we're watching this video today. You guys requested it, so let's get right into it. And before we get into the video, I know I gotta, come on now. I wanted to say rest in peace. My condolences, my love, man, go out to all the fallen people we've lost to these bad cops. Because we do have good cops, man. But people my skin color, man, I just wanted to say people my skin color have died. Back, I don't want to go back. I don't want to turn this into a history class, cause y'all already know where I'm finna go with this, and I don't want to go there. But just want to say my love and rest, my condolences. You know, my love go out, man, to all the people that we lost. You know, some cops are just out here wearing badges and got a gun. They don't care about you. They don't come to protect and serve. So all the cops, you a cop watching this, hey, I hope you're a good cop. I love my skin color. People die my skin color messing with you cops. You pigs. You fat pigs. You donut shop eating fat fucks. But hey, there's some good cops out there. Some wonderful people, man. I've met some amazing cops, especially because I do a lot of racing, street racing, I'm in car groups and all kind of stuff, and hey, so there are some amazing cops. I've met amazing cops. Shout out to all my cops that are good people, but all my bad cops, you gotta get out the chat right now, leave a video right now. This video's not for you. But it's your boy, okay, Rick. Don't get a look at gang, you're not part of that, coming from part of the game. Only make you smile, only make you laugh, and only good vibes only on this channel. Did I say that wrong? Only make you laugh, only make you smile, and only good vibes on. Yeah. I'm feeling too good today, y'all, but we got UK cops versus US cops. Let's get right into it. Hey, man. License and registration. Bitch.
The
good cop, the bad cop, or even the rebel with a cause cop kind of shows in the 70s have evolved into more realistic series such as The Wire, which give us a more nuanced version of police work and those that do it. In real life, dashcam footage from police vehicles has also become a staple in the online content we consume. Today we are going to concentrate on real life cops and perhaps the two most famous, sometimes infamous police forces in the world in this episode of the Infographic Show, American Cops versus British Cops. Don't forget to subscribe.
British Cops, American Cops versus British Cops. Yes, sir.
Click the bell button so that you can be part of our notification squad. Prior to what we consider an actual police force, the ancients had many ways to police the polis or city. Slaves in ancient Greece would handle the rowdy crowds when tempers flared, while the Romans might set the Praetorian Guard on out of control rioters. Through the ages, there have been myriad ways to maintain public order, and also some pretty gruesome punishments for those that breach the accepted rules. In the UK, it wasn't until 1749 when a judge named Henry Fielding created what was called the Bow Street Runners, the first time Britain had anything what we can associate with today's police force. As British cities grew at a rapid pace under the Industrial Revolution, so did crime. And so on September 29th, 1829, the Metropolitan Police Service was formed in London, and it is said to be the first modern police force ever created. The man behind it, Sir Robert Peel, explained why England needed cops. I want to teach people that liberty does not con-
Sir, y'all, England, y'all need them cops down there. Shout out to the UK Well, drill yo is. Shout out to the UK drill. If you from the UK drill, man, show love in the comments and leave a like on the video, man. Y'all know y'all need to leave a like right now because my grandma is also doing 25 years in jail right now because she was twerking outside McDonald's and she was selling her pornos outside Walmart. So we need to get my grandma out of jail, y'all. She did get out, but she went back because they caught her again on a double charge. You know, she was on a double charge. So I don't know how that worked, but she basically couldn't break this bond.
In having your house robbed by organized gangs of thieves and in leaving the principal streets of London in the nightly possession of drunken women and vagabonds. Why were they nicknamed Bobbies? Well, after their founder, Robert. As you know, the USA was noted for its Wild West outlaws.
Bobbies. I'm not sure if I'm right or not, but y'all call UK cops or people down in the UK, y'all call cops Bobbies? Bobbies. 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 Oh shit, Bobby coming. Oh shit, hey, oh, there go Bobby. There go Bobby. Hey, dude, there's a Bobby over there. Slow the fuck down, bro. Slow the fuck down, dude. Do y'all really call cops Bobbies down there?
One of those was Billy the Kid, who was shot by Sheriff Pat Garrett in 1881. Like Britain, America had ways to control crime, but for a long time there was no
formal police force,
and so the job of keeping folks in line often went to private contractors such as the Pinkerton National Detective Agency. Systems including night watchmen, and even what some called goons for hire, weren't workable as the USA grew in population. It's thought that the first American formal police force was created in Boston in 1838, New York City followed in 1845, and by the 1880s, just about all American cities...
They be explaining stuff on here that niggas don't not know at all. Like, this is like I'm in class. Billy, get off your phone, pay attention to the board, you're coming up next and you're going to explain to the class the key points of this video. Hey, they be coming clutch, no cap.
Organized police force. Now that we know something about the history of these two countries' police forces, let's look at the present day. The number of police officers in just England and Wales has decreased significantly in the last decade, which has become a major political issue in the UK. The number
in UK, y'all don't got no pigs down there, UK. What are UK pigs? What are cops in the UK? There ain't no cops in the UK, ain't it? Ah, ain't that something? You come down here to America, y'all, there's cops as soon as you walk out your door of your home. There's a cop on the street doing nothing. He's literally getting paid to do nothing. People are losing their life. People are dying. People are sex trafficking. People are getting killed, murdered. But he's on the corner right there making sure everybody goes 15 in the neighborhood. Or that nobody runs that stop sign nobody cares about in the neighborhood. That stop sign hasn't caused one car crash yet, but he's sitting there waiting for somebody to run that stop sign in the neighborhood. Because he has nothing to do, because there's so many cops out here in the U.S. But there's still bad things going on that shouldn't be going on. But he's sitting at the stop, he's hiding in the bush over there to see if anybody runs the fucking stop sign. It is terrible down here, y'all. It is too, I gotta go to the UK because, but you know, y'all don't got that many cops though, so shit, that might be a bad decision, huh?
2016 of officers in the force was 124,066, down from 143,769 7 years before that. The number of full-time officers working in Scotland in 2016 was 17,242, and the number in Northern Ireland was 6,773. That's a total of 148,081 police officers working all over the United Kingdom. The population of the UK is 65.64 million, so roughly there is one police officer for every 448 people. Much of the British media and the public are saying that is not enough, especially as the crime rate rise in the UK is rising faster than it has in a decade. This includes a rise in violent crimes and homicide. Over the pond in the USA, crime rates are much higher, and as some police departments are looking more like military units, the role of police in society has met with some controversy. Finding the actual number of sworn police officers...
Bro, what? Let me do my research real quick, y'all. Golly.
Working in the USA in 2016 isn't that easy. This is because figures given by the US Bureau of Justice Statistics haven't been updated in a few years. The total number of police agencies in the US is around 18,000, but that includes all branches of police. If we take just local police departments, that number is more like 15,500, according to PolitiFact. The old data that is often cited said that in 2008, there were 765,000 officers that had the power to make an arrest. The US Department of Justice gives the number of 750,340 for 2012. According to the National...
I told y'all, it's too many officers. I feel like I've watched this video before, but I don't remember it. Let me make sure something, dude. No, I haven't seen this video before. I haven't. I'm just getting those vibes, y'all. Like, I've... It's so many cops down here, y'all. Like, from this video here, it's increased like crazy. Like, everybody here is a cop. Like everybody. Like, patrol, constable, sheriff, state trooper. Nigga.
That number has shot up and is presently about 900,000. The U.S. population...
Yeah, it's probably over millions of cops here. Like there's millions of cops here. Like, swear to... Bro, there's so many cops here, there's different names, like I just said, like, constable, state trooper, sheriff, patrol officer, guy that watches the corner of the neighborhood, like...
123.1 million, so that means that roughly there is one cop for every 359 people. One of the major differences is that in the USA, police...
Every 359 people, bro, there's... Do you know how many cops that is, fam? This cop can watch a group of people down here in the U.S., y'all.
36% of American households, according to the Washington Post. It's reported that in 2016, 135 police officers died in the line of duty, with around half of those that died being fatally shot. The Guardian reports that the number of officers killed in the line of duty in the UK is a total of 11 since 2010, although many officers are assaulted in the UK. In 2015, it was reported that 23,000 assaults occurred against officers in just England and Wales. In 2017, the Police Federation of England and Wales reported this figure to be not even close to the real number. It said there were 2.4 million assaults in 2016, meaning an officer was attacked every 13 seconds that year. 300,000 of them involved attacks with deadly weapons. The report said the average police officer is assaulted 19 times a year. On the other hand, in the USA in 2016, police officers killed a total of 1,093 people. According to inquest.org, in the UK in 2016, a total of 5 people were shot and killed by police. The total number...
What? That mean I gotta come to the UK? Rest in peace to all the fallen soldiers, like I said at the beginning of the video, bro. People my skin color. It's like people that work down here with the U.S. law enforcement. They didn't sign up to protect and serve. Protect and serve for the people. They didn't come there for the people. They hate people. I don't know why y'all don't want to hear this, but I got to keep it real. I'm always keep it real in my videos. They hate. Hatred is a big word. Hate. My skin color. A black man. A powerful, healthy, beautiful black man. Even though I'm ugly, I'm still beautiful. Take your girl on a date and she gonna pay for it. But they hate us. They kill us. We had to fight for our freedom. And we still don't have freedom. We was born into slavery. Hatred. Stereotyped. All because of the color of our skin. I don't want to take y'all to class in history, but you know the history. If you know the history, man, it gets deep. And I would go on here explaining, but I don't want to keep this a long video of me ranting and having people go come for me. And we have and I got to come with a big debate. You know what I'm saying? That's not how I want this video to end, but it's true. I love my skin color. If you're my skin color, I love you. And if you're not my skin color, I love you. I show positivity to everybody. You're no more of a human than me. We all bleed the same. We're all equal. You might look a little different. You might have hair on your nose. I might have hair on my over here or right here. My eyes might be right here. Yours might be in here, right here. You know, we're all equal though, man. Don't ever get that mixed up. It's all love, man. I would never. Nah, we don't do that over here on this channel. We don't do that over here.
Shot and killed in the UK since 1990 is 67. We should add here that regular cops in the UK don't carry guns, but armed police can be called when it's thought guns are needed. Police in Northern Ireland are different, routinely carrying firearms. According to the newspaper The Mirror, in 2016 there were 1,863,524 legally owned guns in Wales and England, most of which were shotguns. It's thought there are another 277,000 guns in Scotland and a further 150,000 legally owned guns in Northern Ireland. The same newspaper said there were another 2 million.
But y'all look at the numbers that's finna happen in America of how much guns we have. We'll just
guns
watch.
On the UK streets, watch. Which has raised the question if the UK police should be given firearms. The murder rate per capita in the US is still 30 times higher than in the UK, which might not be surprising considering there are more guns than people in the country.
Niggas dying left and right down
assaults
here.
Assaults on officers, there were 51,548 assaults against US police officers in 2015, with a total of 14,453 injuries sustained. With this in mind, how does life on the job compare between the two forces, and how do you even get a job as a police officer? In the UK, you can join when you are 18. There are no restrictions on height, but the force does ask you to be in good enough physical and mental shape to undertake police duties. No formal qualifications are required, but you will need to pass some tests to get in. Pass them, and you are in, just as long as you haven't committed any serious offenses in the past. It's similar in the US, although the police force does usually ask for a high school diploma, and that you are either 18 or 21, depending on the department. You'll have to train at a police academy and have either a clean criminal record or have only committed minor offenses. There is no minimum or maximum height or weight limit, but in the academy you'll have to pass certain physical agility tests. Nowhere does it state you have to enjoy eating donuts. Wages vary, but in England, Wales, and
hey, here's some fat cops down here that look like they can barely run. Like, Fat Bob is sitting on the corner right here, and his stomach is touching the fucking steering wheel. But I'm guessing Bob passed that agility test 30 years ago.
In Ireland, you can expect to start your career as a police constable on anything from $25,000 to $30,000. If you work hard, UK career websites say that within about 7 years, that wage can be $48,870.
Yeah, so yeah, I'll start off at like $30,000, $25,000, yeah.
US dollars. You should work a 40-hour week, although police work can often mean overtime and also emergency call-outs. You'll get 23 days annual leave and also full sick pay. The pension varies depending on time worked, but the average police pension in the UK is thought to be around $20,465 a year, and the normal retirement age is 60. In the US, salaries differ from state to state, but a rookie cop working in the NYPD can expect to earn $46,288 per year. After 5.5 years, this could rise to $90,829 if you have done well. Other states have average wages closer to $30,000 and others $70,000, according to career website Crom. You'll get 10 days paid vacation to start with, but after 5 years, it will increase to 27 days. You'll also receive unlimited fully paid sick days, medical benefits, dental benefits, and optional retirement after 22 years on the force. Like the UK, you will work around 40 hours a week in shifts, but that might change with overtime. How much pension you receive can be affected by multiple factors, but various websites put the average police pension anywhere from $58,000 to $62,000. With money in mind, we'll end the show there. Where would you...
I feel like it's just, I gotta go to the UK, bro. Like, it's just, niggas dying down, niggas, it's bad down here, y'all. I gotta get out the US, bro. But y'all let me know stuff I missed. Let me know stuff in the comments. Let me know right now, you feel me? How you feel about the UK and the US cops. And hey, I love you guys. Remember to always block out negative people, negative energy, negative vibes, and always stay positive. I'll catch y'all in the next video. Bye.